Hello everyone, this is Crota giving you a shoutcast between Argos Zenith and Sangkyon Rera here on Metalopolis. Here we have Sangkyon spawning as the yellow Terran player at the 8 o'clock position. Meanwhile, we have Argos Zenith spawning over here at the what I'll call the 7 o'clock position as the purple Protoss. So this is going to be Terran versus Zerg here on Metalopolis. Should be an interesting matchup here. Now Argos Zenith, I have casted a number of his replays. I do know him through email, and he sent me this replay saying that it was fairly interesting. Hopefully he does not disappoint. Now we have a drone already moving out. Now I'm kind of curious about the positioning on this drone. He may be trying to do some sort of mind game here, activating this Onaga Watchtower, trying to make sure that there is no liftoff strategy that Sangkyon tried to do, and now moving away with this drone to the opposite corner. Now this Overlord, as it comes in, will spot this SCV. So the SCV also spots that Overlord, and now what I believe Argos wanted to do was try to do some sort of trick where he tried to feint that he was spawning over here or over here as well, but it's not going to work. As now this drone going to come in, is he going to try to delay that barracks? Will he be able to? No, not in time. As we already see Argos Zenith sitting at 13 over 18 food, we do see the extractor already going up. So extractor before spawning pool. Now Argos Zenith opening up pretty big. Argos Zenith, I've seen his replays a lot, and I've seen him do a lot of what I would consider a lot of really strong macro play. He is a really strong macro player. His micro, not quite as good as his macro. As a spawning pool now going to be laid down, this SCV just running around on the inside of this base, not quite sure what exactly the strategy is going to go for, as he's seen that 12 over 18 food. So economically, he is kind of hurting. And now canceling and constantly just building up an extractor and canceling it once again. Back over here, we do have a double racks build. So a double racks build now being thrown down, and I do not believe Argos yet. Argos does know about this double racks build, as this Overlord was able to get sight on it, but I'm still curious as to what exactly the strategy is going to be, as now there's a bunker being placed down over here. I really like Sangkyon throwing down this bunker at the natural expansion, as a Terran player can salvage that building, get those minerals back, and deny that natural expansion anyways. So Argos now throwing down this 14, or what I saw to be a 13 spawning pool, will be able to get that that metabolic boost very, very quickly, along with some early queens and a zergling as well. So as soon as that, I believe, gets up to 100 minerals, we will see the training on that metabolic boost. Back over here, the extractor now finally taking damage. But that extractor will be a little bit late, so all he really has to worry about for quite some time are zerglings. Back over here, this SCV trying to finish this bunker, however, taking some damage as well, as these zerglings are now going to make their way over. Metabolic boost now being researched. Drone coming off the mineral line as these zerglings start attacking this bunker over here. This bunker will get canceled, most likely, as this SCV will not be able to complete it. Back over here, extractor nearly killed by this marine, down to 80, 70, 70, 62 hit points. Yeah, there's some more marines over here. I was wondering how that one marine was able to deal that much damage. As those zerglings now move out across the field, there is one zergling here trying to get sight of that SCV, but hiding behind, and now in comes the zergling trying to do some hits, and down goes that SCV. So poor SCV, as these zerglings move across the map and try to hit over here. There are some marines on this high ledge, so those marines will be able to shoot any zerglings that try to come too close to this ledge over here. Back over here, we do see some zerglings now kind of run in and just completely ignore that SCV, as there is a command center now being placed over here. I like the positioning on this command center just because it creates another sort of seal off of any sort of baneling bus. Those units would have to try to run through here, fairly difficult, as these marines are now going to be able to start shooting at those zerglings over there. SCV running along the far corner as a hatchery now being laid down by Argos. Back over here, we do see double gas already. So double gas off of a really late build, and now I should expect to see some sort of factory or some sort of tech lab play, as marines are going to get underneath that Overlord, and that Overlord doesn't stand a chance. Down it goes, pop. There we go, as we now have a factory coming into position as well. We do not see the factory being laid down there, as an SCV now going to come around that corner, and a queen coming down that ramp. That queen going to be off the creep. However, because Argos knows that these marines were trying to shoot down this Overlord earlier, that queen will not, or that queen is fairly safe in this position by the time this hatchery does hatch. Back over here, we do have a zergling on patrol, quickly going to find an SCV. SCV now once again taken down over there, so two scouting SCVs have been taken down, as this command center will be completed to an will be completed and maybe upgraded to an orbital command. No, just straight lifted off. And now, taking a look at the harvester count, we have 20 harvesters for Sangkyon versus Argos is 25. And we should probably see some Hellions, I'm assuming, at some stage, and to try to restrict the amount of mining that is going to be coming out from Sankeyon. And now we also get the Mobius Reactor. The Mobius Reactor, that's a curious build, as that's the Ghost Academy's ability to be able to start off with 25 energy. I do not see Ghost now being trained, but I've never seen a Ghost build first. So Ghost before any Hellions or Starport. Are we going for an early nuke is the question. And now an Overseer in the base. Are we going to get some sort of contaminate? No, Marines now trying to get underneath. And that Overlord, Overseer moving very slowly at 1.88. Those Marines may be able to shoot it down. And that's going to be a loss of 100 gas and 150 minerals. By the time that those units pull away, another Overlord here. That Overlord down to 22 hit points, 4 hit points. There it goes. And wow, not looking good. Back over here, we do have a swarm of Zerglings in the center of the map, 1,075, so that is a lot of Zerglings in the middle of the field with more Zerglings along the way. We do, taking a look, we do finally have some Ghosts now being trained. Ghosts coming out with 25 and having some additional energy as those Zerglings now going to just swarm these bunkers over here. Ghosts not moving over to try to defend. There are some SCVs, but those Ghosts really need to rack up some kills there. One going to be able to get some kills pretty quickly as they deal 20 damage per attack on those Zerglings, but they attack fairly slowly at only 1.5. Are we going to see any sniper rounds is the question. Are those Ghosts going to try to snipe down some of those Zerglings as those mules? And now more Zerglings coming in to deal a lot of damage. We do have a liftoff of that orbital command center, and those Zerglings are now going to try to run up. No, not going to run up, not be able to find that supply depot down. Those Ghosts are going to be able to protect that expansion over there. But still, a lot of Zerglings causing a lot of pressure for Sankeyon. Back over here, we do have two queens on the low ground, harvester-wise, 25 to 31. So Argos in the definite advantage. And now more Zerglings poking away. Orbital Command down to 500 hit points and losing another bunker. We do have one medevac here. And now those Zerglings are just dancing and doing backflips. What? I'm not quite sure what that was about. But I believe I saw a Zergling do a backflip right by that engineering bay. Back over here, we do, and let's see, we do not see any other sort of research, but we do have a good number of Ghosts. Army unit combination-wise, we now see this medevac coming in. Two Ghosts, some Marines, and are those Ghosts going to start to snipe those units? And, wow, nice... it never fails. Talk a lot and you sneeze. Back over here, we have some Ghosts who are able to get a snipe off on one of those queens. Those queens do not want to engage as these Ghosts were able to just continue to snipe more and more units. And now Ghosts going a crazy early sniping strategy, getting a lot of kills. So, wow, I do not know how many harvesters were taken down, but we do see Argos now at 24 harvesters compared to Sankeyon's 26. So an early Ghost snipe strategy and more Ghosts and Marines joining this party. I just want to click on one of those Ghosts to see how many kills they do in fact have. And now take a look over here. One of those with 11 kills, the other one with 10. So that is a large number of kills. Marines now just getting swarmed by this whole entire attack here. Ghosts fighting around and Ghosts now getting picked off left and right and now quickly being picked back up, picking up the more expensive of the units and now pulling back. Very nicely done though by Sankeyon. Sankeyon getting a lot of those very, very critical drone kills. However, Argo Zenith has been power droning. So you see that he's sitting on 32 harvesters compared to 26. And now some spine crawlers coming into play. Back over here, we still have some Zerglings. We're able to take down more of these buildings on the low ground. So Sankeyon really hurting now and now going into a mass barrack strategy. I'm kind of surprised I don't see a reactor on the starport though. The starport would probably be a good addition for that reactor just to train up more and more units. Orbital Command here finally lifting off and going to try to come down here, but there are some more Zerglings, and that Orbital Command deciding against it and landing once again, and perhaps going to try to train up more SCVs. One Ghost spawning on the wrong side of the map, on the wrong side of the supply depot, and will he be able to deal some damage? You're going to go ahead and come up and not be spotted by those Zerglings. Raise up that supply depot, raise up that supply depot. Okay, at some point, Sankeyon should raise up that supply depot so that he doesn't get swarmed. There are a good number of Ghosts still, and now in comes one Overseer. That Overseer has, I believe, was going to try to do some sort of contaminate, but I haven't seen it yet, as now Ghosts are moving out. Production-wise, we see a lot of reactors now being thrown down, so this is going to be a crazy mass marine build. You see Sankeyon sitting on almost 2,000 or 1,500 minerals. That's a lot of minerals. He's just training up Ghosts and Marines. SCVs now coming down. Ghosts now dropping in to start sniping once again. So a lot of these Ghosts getting tons and tons of kills. As another Overseer, going to quickly get shot down. No, try to move away and quickly sniped down by those a ghost. So wow, ghost with an amazing snipe game. I should just call this snipe Orama. My goodness, a lot of Marines now being trained up. The combat shield and the snim packs have been researched as an SDV finally moves out. Argo Zenith, probably a little bit curious as to what he's going to try to do at this stage. He cannot go Hydralis. Hydralis are just going to get torn apart by those mutilists. By those ghosts. Sorry, he cannot go mutilist because those ghosts are going to tear apart. He really needs to see some roaches with that movement speed upgrade. Combat, we do see some stim pack now as these ghosts and Marines now moving out. Another Overlord going to get caught in midfield and get taken down as these ghosts once again on the move. We do have the centrifugal hooks being researched, so Banelings may be able to bust in. Those ghosts do take two sniper rounds to pop a Baneling before they get within that zero range. Over here, we do have some infestors as well. So we should have some fungal growth followed by a Baneling. And now in comes this army here. A lot of Marines. And now in comes those Overlord. And oh, this is going to be bad. Are we going to see a lot of popping? And yes, there we go. Pop down goes a lot of those ghosts there. And that is just a horrible sight. And now Sankeon being forced to pull back. If those ghosts, if all the Banelings were right here, that would have been the end of that whole entire push. Wow, as those infestors would have been able to fungal growth all of those units. Infestors now moving out. So this is going to be a caster game. And what a game this is going to be as we now have a large number of Marines once again on the move. Marines going to find a Roach Warren and one Spinecrawler and a group of Queens. Marines quickly dropping out. They're going to start taking down a lot of these units here. Zerglings trying to swarm. No, a Baneling's now moving in with that centrifugal hooks. All of those units are being forced to pull back. And now, are they going to drop over here? But there is a group of Banelings right here as well. No, not going to drop on them. That would have been absolutely deadly to try to drop on top of that over there. We do have some infestors now still moving across the map. And I do not see any missile turrets or any ravens. So these infestors may get some crazy, crazy damage. And are they going to be able to run up that ramp and then start spawning infested Terran, taking down all of these SCVs? I do not know. As we are now, we may have another drop over here. But now the infestors now making their way into the base. A drop over here. Not quite sure what's going to happen. Baneling's trying to run away. Marines over here just in the air. Not going to be able to drop anytime soon. As these infestors are making their way into this base. Back over here. Are we going to get a drop? It looks like we are going to get a drop. Marines now dropping over here. Infestors are going to be over here. So who's going to be able to deal more damage? There is, a couple queens now burrowed. So those queens are burrowed. And now all that needs to happen is infestors. Yeah, infested Terran now being spawned all across the map inside here. And all of these Marines running for their lives as there are so many infested Terrans now hatching in this space. Back over here, Marines may do some sort of other drop. No, are they going to do another drop? There are some Banelings up on that top side. Those medevacs cannot drop. But now this main command center has been taken down. So infested Terran completely destroying the starting location and all of these Marines. So now we see Sankeon stuck into one base. Over here, we do have Marines and Marauders trying to take down this hatchery over here. Stay tuned for part two of this replay between Argo Zenith and Sankeon Wera here on Metalopolis.